you ever come across a bully? Someone who forces other people to do what he or she wants, no matter what. Someone who always wants to get his or her own way. What do you think the best way is to deal with such a person? Hello everyone, I'm Kathleen Pelly. Welcome to Journey with Story. Today's episode is an encore episode of an old Cajun folktale about two big bullies, a whale and an elephant, who think they can rule all the other animals because they are bigger than them. But little brother rabbit teaches these two bullies a lesson they won't soon forget. Thanks so much to all of our wonderful Patreon subscribers who do so much to support this podcast. We really appreciate all of you so much and hope you're enjoying our colouring sheets and other perks. If you would like to become a Patreon subscriber, you can sign up at www.journeywithstory.com. Just click on the Patreon button. And thanks to some new unicorn Patreon subscribers, to Rillian, Orion and Rowan for being such loyal fans and becoming unicorn subscribers. Now, let's take an encore journey with How Brother Rabbit Fooled the Whale and the Elephant. One day, little Brother Rabbit was running along on the sand, lippity-lippity, when he saw the whale and the elephant talking together. Little Brother Rabbit crouched down and listened to what they were saying.
"You're the biggest thing on the land, Brother Elephant," said the whale. "And I am the biggest thing in the sea. If we join together, we can rule all the animals in the world and have our way about everything." "Ah, very good, very good," trumpeted the elephant. "That suits me. We will do it."
Little Brother Rabbit snickered to himself.
"They won't rule me," he said. He ran away and got a very long, very strong rope. And he got his big drum and he hid the drum a long way off in the bushes. Then he went along the beach till he came to the whale.
"Oh, please, dear strong Mr. Whale," he said. "Will you have the great kindness to do me a favour? My cow is stuck in the mud a quarter of a mile from here, and I can't pull her out. But you are so strong and so obliging that I venture to trust you will help me out." The whale was so pleased with the compliment that he agreed at once. "So," said the rabbit, "I will tie this end of my long rope to you, and I will run away and tie the other end round my cow. And when I am ready, I will beat my big drum. When you hear that, pull very, very hard, for the cow is stuck very deep in the mud."
"Ha!" grunted the whale. "I'll pull her out if she's stuck to the horns."
Little Brother Rabbit tied the rope end to the whale and ran off, lippity-lippity, till he came to the place where the elephant was.
"Oh, please, mighty and kindly elephant," he said, making a very low bow, "will you do me a favour?"
"What is it?"
asked the elephant. "My cow is stuck in the mud about a quarter of a mile from here," said Little Brother Rabbit, "and I cannot pull her out. Of course you could, if you will be so very obliging as to help me."
"Oh, certainly," said the elephant grandly, "certainly."
"So," said the Little Brother Rabbit, "I will tie one end of this long rope to your trunk and the other to my cow. And as soon as I have tied her tightly, I will beat my big drum. When you hear that, pull, pull as hard as you can, for my cow is very heavy."
"Oh, never fear,"
said the elephant. I could pull 20 cows. Oh, I'm sure you could, said the rabbit politely. Only be sure to begin gently and pull harder and harder until you get her. Then he tied the end of the rope tightly round the elephant's trunk and he ran away into the bushes. There he sat down and beat the big drum. The whale began to pull and the elephant began to pull, and in a jiffy the rope tightened till it was stretched as hard as it could be.
This is a remarkably heavy cow, said the elephant, but I'll fetch her.
And he braced his forefeet in the earth and gave a tremendous pull.
Dear me, said the whale, that cow must be stuck mighty tight.
And he drove his tail deep in the water and gave a marvellous pull. He pulled harder, the elephant pulled harder. Pretty soon the whale found himself sliding toward the land. The reason was, of course, that the elephant had something solid to brace against. And also, as fast as he drew the rope in a little, he took a turn with it round his trunk. But when the whale found himself sliding toward the land, he was so provoked with the cow that he dove head first down to the bottom of the sea. That was a pull. The elephant was jerked off his feet and came slipping and sliding to the beach and into the surf. He was terribly angry. He braced himself with all his might and pulled his best. At the jerk, up came the whale out of the water.
Who is pulling me?
Spouted the whale.
Who is pulling me?
Trumpeted the elephant. And then each saw the rope in the other's hold.
How is this?
Cried the whale.
I thought I was pulling Brother Rabbit's cow.
That is what I thought, said the elephant. Brother Rabbit is making fun of us. He must pay for this. I forbid him to eat a blade of grass on land because he played a trick on us.
And I will not allow him to drink a drop of water in the sea, said the whale.
But Little Rabbit sat in the bushes and laughed and laughed and laughed. Ha ha, much do I care, he said. I can get all the green things I want. And I don't like salt water. Well, three cheers for little Brother Rabbit, right? He did such a good job of teaching those big bullies, whale and elephant, a lesson, didn't he? What do you think the story's souvenir is? Yes, maybe bullies beware because someone smaller and weaker than you on the outside may just be a lot cleverer and stronger than you on the inside, right? Cheerio then. Join me next time for Journey with Story.
Music and post-production was by Colette Jonas.